Power Platform really is helping to change the relationship across organizations, all the way from the business units to IT, as well as professional developers. Now, by bringing all these roles together under one set of tools, it really helps to accelerate the interactions and fosters a culture of innovation rather than that competing culture where people are trying to figure out what requirements are and then trying to translate that up and down the chain. Now, these structural and cultural shift is really empowering organizations to adapt to the age of AI.
Welcome to the Microsoft Cloud Executive Enablement Series, where we speak with Microsoft Cloud senior leaders and experts about the latest trends in technologies we're seeing in the market. The goal of this series is to share with you and your teams our perspective on the business value driven by the Microsoft Cloud for our mutual customers and the opportunities for our partners to grow their business with Microsoft.
Welcome back to another episode of the Microsoft Cloud Executive Enablement Series. My name is Amber Weise, and I'm a Senior Technology Specialist on our Power Platform Global Black Belt team here at Microsoft. I get the chance to work with some of Microsoft's most strategic customers by helping create the vision of what's possible with the Power Platform and develop solutions that reshape critical business processes. Joining me today is Ben Walters, who is a senior product manager for our Power Platform business. We're excited to discuss how AI innovations in Microsoft's low-code Power Platform can help our Microsoft partners get ahead of the competition and grow their business to meet their customers' most pressing needs. Ben, thank you for being with us today.
Thanks for having us, Amber. It's great to be here.
Awesome. Well, let's start with the basics. Could you explain what the Microsoft Power Platform is, and more importantly, why should Microsoft partners care about it?
Sure. So the Microsoft Power Platform is a comprehensive low-code solution that really helps empower users and organizations around the world create custom applications, automate workflows with Power Automate, and analyze data. It also goes a step further and allows people to create rich, engaging websites and chatbots as well that can be used both internally and externally to the organization. And it's a real game changer for our partners because it enables them to deliver more innovative solutions faster than ever before.
Yeah, and we know that this space is changing, evolving, and growing really quickly. We actually saw a 50% expansion in Power Platform usage in just the last 12 months. What do you think were the key factors contributing to this growth, and how does that compare to other low-code platforms available on the market?
Yeah, so there are a couple of key factors that really contributed to this growth. The first is really around the toolset itself and how it's built using a user-friendly design with really robust capabilities. Now, when we take that and compare it to other low-code platforms, Power Platform really was validated by Gartner and Forrester as the most widely used low-code application platform even before this expansion. Now, the key differentiator for us lies in our commitment to how we build that innovation and also how we're democratizing the use of AI with features like Copilot, which sets us apart from other low-code platforms in the market.
Yeah, that's quite interesting. So could you provide more details on how organizations are adopting Power Platform for process innovation and leveraging their human capital as well as technology assets more effectively?
Yeah, organizations really are embracing Power Platform as their key process innovation engine. It allows them to both empower business units all the way up to IT teams to work more efficiently together. And by combining human expertise with the technology assets and AI features like Copilot and others within the toolset, they're really able to achieve super impressive results.
So speaking of Copilot and AI, how is Power Platform democratizing innovation, and what kind of growth are you seeing in this, particularly with Copilot and generative AI?
Yeah, that's right. So Power Platform really is democratizing innovation by making AI accessible to all users across the business, from citizen developers all the way up to IT professionals. Now, Copilot, for instance, has been adopted by more than 36,000 organizations worldwide already. And it's really about providing tools that enable users to leverage the AI that is available to them in their day-to-day work. Now, this ultimately drives innovation throughout the business, changing the culture and economics of software at scale to achieve process innovation.
Wow, that's great to hear. Can you share specific benefits that organizations have experienced from implementing Power Platform, especially in terms of time savings and process automation?
Yeah, so one that comes to mind is Rabobank. Now, they saw significant time savings by automating routine tasks. They wanted to give their employees more time for value-adding activities. And Power Platform really helped them achieve this, resulting in better consumer relationships and improved bottom-line results. Now, automation is a real game changer for many organizations, and especially in this instance where they could take processes and put an automation layer on top of that with Power Automate to help drive innovation in their organization.
So it's clear that process innovation is transforming organizations. How is Power Platform facilitating this transformation in both structure and culture within these organizations?
Yeah, so Power Platform really is helping to change the relationship across organizations, all the way from the business units to IT, as well as professional developers. Now, by bringing all these roles together under one set of tools, it really helps to accelerate the interactions and fosters a culture of innovation rather than that competing culture where people are trying to figure out what requirements are and then trying to translate that up and down the chain. Now, these structural and cultural shift is really empowering organizations to adapt to the age of AI.
So process mining is a term that I'm hearing a lot about. How does process mining accelerate the modernization of processes within organizations, and how does that integrate into Power Automate?
Yeah, so process mining is actually one of the newer additions to the Power Platform. And when we think about the way automations have been put in place in the past, we build workflows and we build Power Automate flows, we put them in place and kind of leave them to run without any real idea of the impact they're having on the business beyond that. Now, process mining can leverage the real-world data integrated with Power Automate to help identify bottlenecks and even make suggestions on the way those processes can be improved, be that through additions or changes to that automation flow, to app integrations as well, to help people understand how those processes can be affected, be more effective across the business.
So let's shift into the integration of AI Builder with GPT models. It's really quite intriguing to me. How does this enhance the creation of intelligent agents to assist users in making better decisions?
Yeah, so AI Builder is a really interesting set of functionality within the Power Platform. Historically, when people wanted to build AI models in the business, they needed really large data sets and a lot of training before those models could be used. And they were really implemented for very specific point solutions. Now, AI Builder simplifies the creation of building intelligent agents by allowing users to implement AI models in low code. So this really helps them to do things like analyze purchase orders or even assist in decision making. And it's all about making AI more accessible across the business for all users.
Definitely. So enterprise application templates are another interesting aspect. What are the advantages of using these templates in Power Platform, and how do they simplify customization and implementation for various departments?
Yeah, so building an application to anyone can be a daunting task to start off with. And the enterprise application templates really provide a strong starting point for customization, helping to save time and effort. And they're based on best practices and real-world applications. So what this means is it makes it really easy for departments like finance or HR to take those templates and start to build their own solutions that fit their needs.
So let's talk a bit about partners. Several global partners have achieved impressive results with Power Platform. Could you share more examples of how partners are helping our customers achieve cost savings and cultural transformation?
Of course. Partners are super important to helping our customers achieve their goals and also helping to scale the impact of Power Platform across businesses. Now, one partner actually helped Pacific Gas and Electric save $38.5 million through automation. And it's changes like this that partners are making to really drive measurable impact within businesses.
Microsoft is taking steps to formalize specialization in intelligent automation for partners. Can you tell us a bit more about these initiatives and how pricing and buying options are being optimized for customers?
We're really making a concerted effort to recognize partners who excel in intelligent automation and helping to streamline the pricing and buying options to make it easier for customers to adopt these solutions at scale. Now, it's all about formalizing partnerships and ensuring a seamless experience for our customers.
What incentives and resources are available for partners interested in exploring process mining opportunities, and how can they get involved?
Yeah, so any partners who are interested in exploring process mining opportunities can access resources, trainings, programs, and incentives, and they can find all of this information at the Power Platform Partner Center. They can also engage with us there to explore additional opportunities.
That's awesome. Last question. How can partners become part of the list of those specializing in Power Platform to deliver high impact solutions to customers? And what are the benefits of achieving that type of specialization?
So the best way partners can do this is they can specialize in Power Platform by demonstrating their expertise and delivering high impact solutions to their customers. The benefits once they do this include recognition, additional support, and the opportunity to grow their business by meeting customer needs effectively.
Thank you, Ben, for sharing these valuable insights on how Microsoft's Power Platform and AI innovations are creating exciting opportunities for our partners. It's been a pleasure having you here.
It's been awesome. And if there were three things that people should take away, first of all, is that Power Platform is the best-in-class low-code application platform for their users, providing everything from being able to build apps to workflows to websites to chatbots to help drive innovation in the business. Second of all, is that in this new era of AI, the best way to get your employees access to those services and be able to leverage those to help do their jobs better is with Power Platform. And third and foremost is that there is great opportunity out there for our partners to be able to grow their business and drive impact with their customers with the Power Platform toolset.
Awesome. And that wraps up for today, folks.
Thank you for the time. Really appreciate it.
Microsoft's Power Platform is right on the cutting edge of innovation, and our partners have a great opportunity to make the most of these exciting developments. We can't wait to see how our partners keep delivering success with Microsoft's Power Platform. Thanks all.
And that wraps up today's episode. Don't forget that this episode is a part of a series featuring some of our most experienced and innovative global executives, packed full of great insights and examples of how to make the most out of working alongside Microsoft. If you haven't already, make sure to check out our other episodes. No matter your industry or area of focus, the Microsoft Global Partner Enablement Team is here to enable you and your teams to achieve more. If you want to hear a little more of this episode, we have a podcast which has some more of our discussion and some bonus content. If there's an area of cloud innovation you'd like to hear more about, please send us a note at salesenablement-gsi@microsoft.com so that we can create content that meets your enablement needs. Thank you for listening. Thank you for engaging with us. And thank you for being a Microsoft partner. We'll see you on the next episode of the Microsoft Cloud Executive Enablement Series.